All right, let's get you set up on the labs platform that we're going to be using as part of this course, and that's going to be Qwiklabs. Now let's go through how you're actually going to access each of these labs and perform a lot of the work that we're going to ask of you during this specialization. Now as you work your way through these lessons in Coursera, you're going to start to see labs at the end. Each lab is clearly going to say lab and then the title of the lab. In this case, we're looking at the very first lab, which is getting you started with Qwiklabs, which is lab zero. So what you're going to do inside of Coursera is go ahead and click on that lab title. And inside of Coursera in the lower right-hand corner, you're going to see a button that says Open Tool. That'll actually launch Qwiklabs in another tab in your browser. Once inside of Qwiklabs, you'll see a Start Lab button and a timer countdown as soon as you click Start Lab. Each of the labs are timed, but note that we have padded the estimates a lot, especially for the more complicated labs, upwards of 30 to 60 minutes for you to play around inside the lab and perform the work. Once you do click that Start Lab button, credentials are automatically going to be generated for you on the left-hand side, so make note of your username and password. Now, once you've got that username and password, the next step they're going to ask you to do is actually open up an incognito window and type in console.cloud.google.com, which is going to be the login page for Google Cloud Platform. Now, you notice a big yellow button that says Open Google Console. Now, this won't open it in an incognito window, and you might get some issues if you're already signed in to some of the Google Cloud products, if you have those for your personal accounts. So incognito window first, type in console.cloud.google.com, and then log in to Google Cloud Platform with those auto-generated Qwiklabs credentials, which will then give you access to your sandbox environment for the purposes of this lab. And once you've gone through that lab and you've completed it, when you feel confident you're ready to move on, you can actually click End Lab, which will remove all of your resources, bring you back into the lecture, and you can continue on with the course. Now, one last note is if you're worried about that time counting down to the end of the lab, is you actually get 3 attempts for each lab. So even if you don't complete it within the required amount of time, don't worry, you can attempt it a second or third time. Or if you want additional practice, you can always reopen the lab and practice it again later on down the road.